Dear students, welcome to the second day of online classes. Today we are going to discuss about basics of computer system. Dear students, today I am going to discuss about the basics of computer systems. So in that we are going to discuss about the characteristics of the computer system and classifications of the computer system, history of the computer system and the evolution of the computer systems. These two topics we are going to discuss in upcoming classes. Computer is an electronic device which processes given data to derive required and useful information. Computer is a programmable machine that manipulates data according to a list of instructions. Computer is any device which aids humans in performing various kinds of computations or calculations. Let me see the characteristics of computers. So we know very important characteristics of a computers like speed, accuracy, reliability, storage capacity, automation. So like a way we can know the different variety of characteristics. First one is speed. It is nothing but the computer is able to process the data and gives the output in fraction of seconds, such that required information is given to the user on time, enabling the user to take a right decisions on right time. A powerful computer is capable of executing about 3 million calculations per second. Next, we will see about the accuracy. The accuracy of computers is consistently high, which avoids any errors. All there are errors, error due to errors in the instruction given by program. So it is also relevant with the speed. The next one is reliability. The output generated by the computer is very reliable, but it is reliable only when the data which is passing as input to the computer and the program, which gives instruction are correct and reliability. So next characteristic is storage capacity. A computer has a good storage capacity. Automation. Once the instruction fed into the computer, it works automatically without any human intervention until the completion of execution of program or meets logical instructions. So like a way we can categorize the characteristics of the computer. Next, we will see about classification of computers. The another important parameter in the computer is classifications. We can classify the computers based on the purpose, operation and size. So we can classify it into major categories like according to purpose of the computer, according to the operation of the computer, according to the usage of the computer. According to the purpose of the computer, computers are classified into general purpose computer and special purpose computers. General purpose computers are a computer that are used to general operations. All the PCs which have a general purpose computers. It is only solve the mathematical equations, some basic programs. But special purpose computers is a digital computer which are designed, made and used for any specific job. They are usually used for those purposes which are critical and need great accuracy and response like class satellite launching, weather forecasting, etc. According to the operational principle of computers, they are categorized as analog, digital and hybrid computers. According to the operation, the computers are classified into two types: analog computers and digital computers. Analog computers are not existed now. It is used only for the mathematical operations. It is utilized the variables and mechanical energy or electrical energy to operate it. It is different from a digital computers because of an analog computer can perform several mathematical operations simultaneously. Digital computers are designed to operate on two states, namely zeros and ones. It just deals with the sequences of zeros and ones. Digital computers are suitable only for complex mathematical operations and calculations. Next one is microcomputers. The computer which has the microprocessor with the central processing unit is called a microcomputer, which also have a keyboard and a mouse, a micro level of the input devices, monitors, or the memory, RAM and ROM packaged in a microcomputer. The next, we know that we are familiar about it, that is desktops. A desktop is intended to be used on a single platform. Power consumption is not as critical as that in laptops. Desktops are widely popular for daily use in the workplace and household purposes. Next one is laptop. Similar in operation of desktops, laptop computers are miniatured and optimized for mobile use. Laptops, nowadays we are also using a laptop for online classes. We are using many purposes, we are using the laptops. It runs on a single battery or an external power, that is adapter. They are enabled with an indie board, touchpad, acting as a mouse and a liquid crystal display. That is a display. Nowadays LED displays are available. The portability and capacity to operate on battery have proven be a great help to mobile users. So this is the way we can classify the computers according to the purpose, the size and the usages. The next part of the computer systems is history of computers. So we know very well about the history of computers. Sticks are invented in the 16th initial decade of the 16th century. Next series is abacus. It is used to the simple mathematical calculations and mechanical device. Invented by Babylon 2400 BC. Next one is Napier's bones. It is invented by the John Napier, the mid of the 17th century. It is used to multiply and divide, find the square root, cube root and square of the numbers. Next one is a slide rule, which is also invented at mid of 17th century by William Thrett. It is based on the Napier's ideas about logarithms. It is used primarily for the calculations, multiplications, division, addition, roots, logarithms, etc. The next set of computer is Pascalian. It is invented by the Pascal in 1642. It was its limitation to addition and subtraction. It is too expensive. Takeaway, we can know the different computers in stepped reckoner, Jacquard loom, arithmometer. It is a mechanical calculator invented by the Thomas in 1820. Next one is difference engine and analytical engines invented by Charles Babbage. It is an automatic mechanical machine for the polynomial operations. It is the first mechanical computer. In 19th century, calculating machine invented by Herman. The very beginning of the 20th century, the ENIAC is invented. That is electronic numerical integrator and computer, which is developed by John Prosper. The next set of computer is UNIVAC, then EDVAC. Finally, the first portable computer was developed at in 1981. The first portable computer is Osborne 1, which is developed by Osborne Computer Corporation. Level of computer is tablet. So it is a very familiar one with this on tap keyboard. Uses the touch screen technology and it is very handy to use as a mobile phone. It comes with an on screen keyboard or a user stylus or a digital pen. So nowadays Apple iPad redefined the class of tablet computers. Next topic is evolution of computer systems. So we know that different generations that involves in the evolution, first generation and second generation, third generation and fourth generations. The very first generation involves the vacuum tubes in 1940 to 1956, as well as second generations replacing the vacuum tubes by transistors in 1956 and 1963. One transistor is equivalent to the 40 vacuum tubes. In the first generation, the vacuum tubes are very expensive. The vacuum tubes generates very high heat and to operate the single addition operation. It is also deals with the great level of the electricity, so that it is a high expensive. It is replaced by the transistors in the second generation. The second generation computers are using instructions as a keywords. It allows the users to use the languages from the binary language to the assembly language. The next one is third generation computer, which is deals with the integrated circuits. The development of integrated circuits develops the third generation computers. The transistor is minimized into the single silicon chip, such as semiconductors. It has many number of transistors within IC, that is integrated circuits. It is familiar for its efficiency and speed, accuracy, size occupied. It carry out the instructions in billions per the second. And the next one is fourth generation computer. So the development in the microprocessor, which develops fourth generation computer, it has many number of integrated circuits in a single silicon chip. Also, it improves the accuracy and the speed of the third generation computers. Also, the fourth generation computers are developed for the specific of graphical usage interfacing. Fourth generation computers are designed based on the technology, artificial intelligence, expert systems and robotics, etc. These computers are having high processing speed and very reliable one. The goal is to design this computer is that to respond the natural language input and its organization. It has some applications like voice recognition and face recognition are being used nowadays. So far, we are discussing about basics of the computer systems like characteristics, classifications and history, reliabilities of the computers. And also the evolution of the computers we discussed today. First, we will see about the idea of the computer architecture and technologies performance used in the computer architecture. Thank you.